Today and welcome back. This video, we're going to talk about isothermal and adiabatic changes. We learn about the process and their respective equations to solve any related question. First of all, let's understand about these two processes. Isothermal process is a process where the gas undergoes change of state at constant temperature. Since the internal energy of gas depends on the temperature, so it is constant that delta U is zero during isothermal process. The change in state of gas is based on PV as the constant. In other words, it obeys the Boyle's law and the pressure is inversely proportional to the volume of gas. Based on first law of thermodynamics, we have delta U equal to zero. Hence, we have W equal to delta Q, which can be derived to nRT ln V2 over V1, as we have discussed in the previous video. Now we're going to look at adiabatic process. It is a process where the gas undergoes the change of state without the heat entering or leaving the gas that delta Q is equal to zero. For here, you do not need to learn about the derivation, but the change of state is based on PV to the power of gamma as constant, where gamma is the ratio of molar heat capacity. Another formula would be the TV to the power of gamma minus 1 as the constant. From the first law of thermodynamics, we have delta Q is zero, so we have work done is the negative of delta U. This means that the expansion of gas is supplied by the internal energy of gas since there is no heat supply to the gas. The change in internal energy could be expressed as NCVN dT as discussed before. Now we're going to derive some more formula for the equation of work done during adiabatic process. We start with the integral of PdV where we could substitute P as the constant C divided by the volume to the power of negative gamma. Here is just normal integration which you have learned in MX. Power plus 1, then divide the whole term with the power plus 1, and then you do the substitution of V2 and V1. After that, you could substitute the constant C with the PV to the power of gamma. Simplify the equation, we obtain 1 over 1 minus gamma multiply bracket of P2 V2 minus P1 V1. As we know that gamma is more than 1, we could rearrange the equation as 1 over gamma minus 1 multiply the bracket of P1 V1 minus P2 V2. Beside this formula, we have also learned about gamma is equal to F plus 2 over F from the previous chapter. We can substitute this formula into the equation that gamma minus 1 is 2 over F. So we have W equal to F over 2 multiply bracket of P1 V1 minus P2 V2. And then we can also use the ideal gas equation that PV equal to nRT, and we have W equal to negative F over 2 nR dT, which is one of the formula for internal energy that we have learned in chapter 9. Overall, there are three formulas can be used to calculate the work done during adiabatic process, depend on what are the variables given in the question, such as gamma, degree of freedom, or the molar heat capacity. Let's try one question from past year in 2017. The word insulated here means that the system won't be affected by the temperature surrounding, which is one of the common assumptions you did in the heat experiment during SPM. Therefore, the system here is in adiabatic process. It also mentioned about the diatomic molecule, where you can apply the formula F plus 2 over F to calculate the value of gamma, which will be equal to 1.4 in this case. The gas undergoes expansion, and we need to obtain the final pressure of the gas. What we can do is to apply the ratio of PV to the power of gamma, put in the values as in the equation, the final pressure is 1.9 times 10 to the power of 5 Pascal. The next question is about the work done by the gas. We have the gamma, pressure, and volume. We can apply the equation 1 over gamma minus 1 multiply the bracket of P1 V1 minus P2 V2. Put in the values, the work done is positive 5 joule, which means the work is done by the gas. Next is past year in 2016, a diatomic gas with gamma 1.4. From here, you should be able to see that the value of gamma is unique for each type of molecule, which depends on the number of degree of freedom. This time, the question asks for the temperature. Just apply the formula TV to the power of gamma minus 1 as constant. Remember to always convert the temperature into Kelvin unit. Final temperature is 202 Kelvin. Next is to get the work done. If you want to use the same formula as previous question, you will need to get the final pressure before you apply the formula. Alternative solution is to use the formula from chapter 9 that change in internal energy is equal to F over 2 nRT. For the number of mole, you can substitute the formula that nR is equal to PV over T. Put in the values, the work done is 1.69 times 10 to the power of 3 joule. The last thing to discuss is about the graph. There is a lot of graph you need to understand about the changes based on different processes. It could be isobaric, isochoric, isothermal, and adiabatic process. For this video, we focus on the isothermal and adiabatic process. Let us use the question from trial paper of KELANTAN in 2022 as our case study. We are given with two containers with a movable piston. Both contains nitrogen at 30 degrees Celsius. The gas expands adiabatically in container X, while the gas in container Y expands isothermally to twice of the original volume. Before we plot the graph, let's obtain some information about those two processes. Let's review the isothermal first. We can apply the ratio PV as constant to learn about the pressure. The final pressure will be half of the initial pressure, and this is aligned as what we have learned about isothermal process. Since the pressure is inversely proportional to the volume, hence the pressure is reduced when the gas expands. For temperature, we are maintained as 303 Kelvin since it is an isothermal process. Next is adiabatic process. Remember, we use PV to the power of gamma as constant. From here, we can know that the final pressure is 0.38 of initial pressure. For temperature, we can use TV to the power of gamma minus 1, so make sure you do remember those formulas here for adiabatic process and always convert the temperature to Kelvin unit. Now we're going to look at the graph. You can see the pressure of both containers reduce when the gas expands. For adiabatic process, the pressure is inversely proportional to the volume to the power of gamma. Since gamma is more than 1, the PV graph for adiabatic is more curved compared to isothermal process. This could be explained by how the gas is expanding. In adiabatic process, the internal energy of gas is the cause to do work since there is no heat supply. Hence, the temperature reduces, the volume expands. You could see that the final pressure is reduced to even lower value compared to isothermal process. For isothermal process, the work is purely done by using the heat energy from surrounding. The temperature of gas stays constant, which means the internal energy of gas is also constant. The volume expands, so the final pressure is decreasing, but not as much as in the adiabatic process. So this is one of the examples you could try to explain any of the thermodynamic process. First, remember what we can know about the gas is PV equal to nRT. The major variable would be the pressure, volume, and temperature. Depending on what type of the process is involved, you need to know what is the constant variable, what is the effect, what is the relationship or the equation, and what is the result or conclusion. Let's take isochoric process as the last example in this video. The volume of gas is constant, so the work done is equal to zero. So the equation we have is the delta Q equal to delta U. This means that the heat supply to the gas will be converted to the internal energy of gas. As the temperature of gas increases, the pressure of the gas is also increasing. The rest you can study on your own and try to explain in your own way. So that's conclude my discussion today. If you still have any question, leave it in the comment section below. Also, do leave a like and subscribe to my channel. I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.